What's up, traders? Matt from the Trade Brigade here doing a technical analysis on ticker symbol XAIR for Beyond Air Inc. On the left-hand side, we do have the daily time frame, and on the right-hand side, the 30-minute intraday time frame. First things first, this will be a bit of an update since we talked about it back in this section of the chart, and the main thing to really talk about here is the break of the support trend line, and on today's sort of back test, a little bit of rollover. Now, don't get me wrong, in the post-market, we're currently trading a very, very wide spread. It's about a dollar spread, 1080 by 1180. So I'm not entirely sure what to make of that. We can't really learn anything about it if we turn on the extended hour session, just because the volume that's transacting in the post market is so darn low, right? We're talking about 5,000, not even 4,000 shares in the first 30-minute period after the bell rung. So not going to read into that too much. Let's just assume that we stay within range for tomorrow's session. What else are we noting from the 30-minute intraday time frame chart? Well, certainly this is what's jumping off the page at me. If we come in from the highs, draw in a resistance trend line, you can see that we're constantly getting rejected at that. So now that we've broken the support trend line, you're looking for shorts up against that resistance trend line. And if it happens to tie in once again with a back test of the support trend line, then fine. We also have that 1137 to be watching as well as a short point. So if we start getting into this area and if we start printing inverted hammers, indecision dojis, basically anything that would make you question, is this just a dead cat bounce? Can we flip short underneath the lows and trade lower with a stop over the highs? That would be the place where that happens. Now, are you actually going to trade this one short? Let's go on over to the trade tab, and we'll note that, of course, this is hard to borrow, so you're not going to short the shares, at least easily, and the put side of the option chain is not very attractive whatsoever. So that being said, you're not actually going to short this. You're just going to avoid going long in this instance at that area if that's how it unfolds. The only potential long I could see panning out would be a breakout up and over the resistance trend line. So if we can come into it screaming, good volume, good solid bodied candles doing something like this, there's a potential breakout here towards that 1150 zone, depending on time of day and when that actually unfolds. Maybe it's this 1137. So just in general, this is going to be an inflection point. Now, whether or not it takes it out or rolls over, we'll have to decide that in real time. But I did want to make you aware that 1137, 1140, up to about 1150, treat it as like a 10 cent zone there, is a major inflection point inside of XAIR. If it resolves to the upside, we know that the target is 1252, these recent set of highs in here. And if it resolves to the downside, you're probably, you know, if you want to be conservative and really, you know, wait to see, you know, should I avoid or should I get in? If we take out this low at 1085, what do we have from the daily, right? We basically have a flush point underneath here. Again, you're avoiding, you're probably waiting to see if we get a structural bottom in place at this 1021, noting that maybe the 50 SMA, the blue line there, starts to catch up over time and is going to provide a super support. So those are my thoughts in XAIR as it sits right now. Again, the main thing to talk about is the inflection point at the $11.37 mark. So if you enjoyed the video, if you learned anything new, definitely let me know down below in the comments section or by giving the video a thumbs up. Don't forget our main channel is linked in the description. And all of that being said, I wish you a green trading week.